Hello, this is Eric. This is the environment I created for testing video recording. ESP32-CAM is filming me, and I'm filming this environment with my iPhone. When I'm using ESP32-CAM, I was thinking about how to save it as a file whenever I want. In the mobile application, it was possible to create a video file through FFmpeg, but this had to be developed as another application. Of course, I used to make a Flutter application to save a video as a file. If you know what I've done so far, you know what it is. Anyway, if you configure your system with Raspberry Pi, you can record a video as a file very easily. In fact, you don't even need a Raspberry Pi. It's possible through your regular PC. The point is using VLC Player. As you know, the Raspberry Pi 02W is probably the cheapest, low-performance Linux device out there. It has insufficient RAM and clock speed, so if your project requires a lot of resources, then this is not the right solution for you. But I'm looking for a project where I can do it with this. I believe that many things are possible in simple IoT projects. ESP32-CAM is battery powered and worked as an RTSP server. I have a 7-inch display connected to my Raspberry Pi 02W. It's acquiring the image from ESP32-CAM through the network connection of the VLC player and uploading it to the screen. Pretty simple. In this test, I'm gonna test recording the images obtained from ESP32-CAM as a file. You can record at any time using the built-in feature in the VLC player. All I need is to be able to see a live view and be able to record at any time. This is probably the most basic IP camera function. This time, ESP32-CAM works as an RTSP server and operates like an IP camera through a local network connection. I will access it from the VLC player on Raspberry Pi 02W so I can see a live view and start recording to a file. To sum up, RTSP is a real-time streaming protocol. It provides a command or control function for multimedia stream. Like a UDP, RTSP is a connectionless protocol and each stream is distinguished by a session ID. However, the RTSP command or control request is transferred through the TCP protocol with a guaranteed connection. If you want to study it, please Google it. You can find a bunch of information about it. Also, ESP32-CAM source code I used can be found in the video description below. It's time to have a real test. ESP32-CAM is connected by a battery. Also looking toward my tablet screen. I'm gonna try to record for an hour from now. Let's record the stopwatch to check if there is anything missing time. On the VLC player, you can find the menu Open Network Stream. Enter the local IP address of your ESP32-CAM in the format above. That's it. Now it's trying to connect it. Here you are, it's connected and I can see my tablet screen. Oh, very nice. Unlike the previous HTTP streaming, it has a buffer of about 2 seconds. I guess it's a time they can cover network delays as well as reconstructing packets of streaming. Let me start the recording. VLC Player has a record function. This will allow you to start recording. Unfortunately, there is no indication that it's currently recording. That's ugly. What we can do is to believe it's working. The resolution of my ESP32-CAM is set to XGA 1020x768. It's bigger than VGA mode. Both devices are working hard right now. During the hour of recording, I didn't experience any network connection problems or heavy frame drops. Let me set it to play my video faster. If not, it takes an hour. Time flies. 1 hour has passed. Let me stop the stopwatch. Go back to the menu and select the record again. This is to stop recording. Recheck the incoming video information. 1 second, let me zoom in on the video screen. Much better. The codec is MJPEG. Since what comes from ESP32-CAM is a JPEG image, it concatenates and shows it as a video stream. The resolution is 1020x768 as mentioned before. Also, the resolution of the buffer is going to be the same. The recorded video files can be found in the default video folder. You can see a few files here, but the last one is the video file I recorded with you. How about this file size? Oh my god, can you see this? It's around 830 megabytes. It takes about 13 megabytes per minute with the XGA resolution. Okay, let's open the file this time. Hope it plays without problems. We can play the video without any problems. It's also reliable. Most importantly, the time I recorded and the length of the video match. I'm happy with this result. My idea is to create an application for ESP32-CAM using the VLC library. This means that you can connect multiple cameras and record at any time. Wouldn't it be possible to build your own surveillance camera system? Okay, this is all I have for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.